It is time to expand minds through movies, TV, sports, and flicks. It is time to boldly go where no podcast has gone before. It is time for the Captain Talks Flicks.
The Captain Talks Flicks.
Welcome to the Captain Talks Flicks podcast. I'm your host, the Captain Cortez, aka Mr. Love, and this is where we talk flicks. I welcome the podcast where me, the Captain, talks about movies, TV, sports, flicks, anything you can see on a tuber screen. I like to get in here and give my unique perspective, because after 46 years of being on planet Earth, I've developed a new perspective about these movies, TV, sports, and flicks, and I'd like to get here and tell you about it. Because just maybe you care. In accord to the stats, it looks like you do care. I want to give a big shout out to France. Got some plays over in France this past week. Gracias, gratitude, d'au revoir, and France. I made that cassoulet. And let me tell you this. The cassoulet I made was absolutely fantastic. It was so good. I made the recipe I found online, and I'm going to say, man, it is so delicious, especially in the wintertime. It was so good. I can only imagine that having cassoulet in France would be just absolutely spectacular, because mine, the one I made, I never made it for the first time, was fantastic. Having it in France, oh my gosh, this must be just out of this world. So one of these days, I'm going to have to fly over to France, visit the Eiffel Tower, and have me some cassoulet, bro. So good. So thanks for listening. God bless, gratitude. And just FYI, back day with School Bay Radio DJ. But I never got a job. I think I never got a job because I just didn't have the vision. If I just would have had the vision, maybe that would enable me to become a radio DJ. But it didn't. It allowed me to become the greatest podcaster in the Matrix. Something to debate might be true, might not be true. But I said it on the internet. So it's got to be true, right? Because everything on the internet is facts, not facts, propaganda, fake news, the Matrix, planes, trains, automobiles, roads, star, moon, sun. I don't know. I didn't make the internet. Ask the people that made the internet. So when you're online, just be aware, just watch out. Anyways, I could ramble here all day, but I won't. Let's get right into the podcast. But first, a word from our sponsor. Ladies and gentlemen, life can get pretty hectic. So when it gets hectic, you probably should take some time to rest and relax. Now there's many ways you can rest and relax. There's a lot. But I hear one of the more popular ways to rest and relax is doing a puzzle. A lot of people are doing puzzles these days. I've done them before. They're very relaxing. I understand why people are doing them. So if you want to relax with a puzzle, we got some puzzles for you over at the Existing Fictions at the store, so you can relax and do a cool puzzle. And guess what? The Captain took some of those pictures. Some of those puzzles have pictures that I took with my own camera. So if you want to do a puzzle that the Captain took a picture of, I'll put a link below the Existing Fictions at the store, and you can relax with a puzzle that I took some of the pictures of. Yeah, very cool. So yeah, check out the link. Now let's get on the podcast. Ladies and gentlemen, I am back. And 2023 has just started. We're still very early in the year. Have you chosen to say, bro, we're going to start making some moves this year? 22 is kind of blah. We still kind of recovering from the pandemic. Nah, it's a wrap. It's time to start doing work. It's time to handle business. It's time to reshape this reality. I want a better life. I'm making better choices. Is that what we're doing? Yeah, maybe we should. Maybe we should just start making better choices and reshape our reality. Are you with me? Let's get it. Let's make 23 prosperous. Live longer, prosper like Spock says. Yeah, let's do that. Yeah, so that's so cool. New Year's here. And now let me get into the podcast. So this week, you know what happened? I went back to Tulsa. I went back to Tulsa, bro. And I became a king. I became the king of Tulsa. Did I? Not really. But I watched the king of Tulsa. I watched the show Tulsa King with Stallone. Starring as the General Dwight. Yeah, the gangster show set in Tulsa. That's what I watched this week. I watched it again because I'm loving the show. It's so great. So I'm going to get into that today. But first, a couple things. First of all, there will be spoilers. And second of all, I do own some shares at Paramount. I just want to be clear and transparent just to let you know. And so now that I've told you that, let's get into Tulsa King, Adobe Walls. So yeah, like I said, I went back to Tulsa. And let me just say this, we're like 8 episodes in deep. And I gotta say this, this gangster show is like no other gangster movie or show I've ever seen in my life. It's a very unique spin on the gangster tale. I was watching it today and just reflecting back on the other episodes. I'm like, I don't think I've seen a gangster show quite like this. It's like a blend of a lot of other shows into one. It's a very unique spin on the gangster tale. And I'm loving it. I'm here for it. I'm loving it. It's so interesting. Every week, I can't wait to see what happens. And like I said last week, Dwight just keeps getting in deeper. Being a gangster is tough. I'm like, man, one thing after another just doesn't stop. I was like, man, the problems just don't stop. I'm like, man, being a gangster is so hard. I'm so glad I'm not a gangster. So yeah, but you know, like I said last episode, Dwight just is really good at handling them. Every problem comes his way, he just handles them so masterfully. I mean, that's what happens when you become 70 years old. When you become 70 years old, you figure out how to handle all the adversity that comes your way. Yeah, he's a master at that. It's like every episode will say, let's see what kind of problems Dwight has and see how he masterfully handles them, because that's all he's been doing. Problem comes his way, he masterfully handles it. So yeah, that's why they call him the general, I'm sure, because it seems like he is a general when it comes to dealing with that stuff. So anyways, the episode's fantastic. Like I said, some problems came Dwight's way and he masterfully navigated them. Yeah, fantastic. But I want to go a little deep in the episode like I normally do. And one thing I noticed about the show this week is like, man, you know, be careful who you surround yourself with, right? You got to be very choosy who you let in your sphere, in your circle, bro. Because some choices from other human beings could affect your life. And we've seen that firsthand in Tulsa King this week. We saw the character, I don't know her name, is a lady. And she's talking to Dwight like, Dwight, you caused us some problems, Dwight. Like, we're just regular people and you caused all this heat, right? And, you know, because she's associated with him, his problems become her problems, right? And I'm sitting there thinking like, man, when you're out here in the real world, you better be careful who you surround yourself with, because you don't want their problems to become your problems. You want to associate with people going places, doing things, becoming great, and mitigate problems as much as possible. Because it's one thing I can say for sure. Every human being on planet Earth, no matter what walk of life, no matter what gender, race, nationality, age, I can say probably for sure that we don't like problems. Who likes problems, right? Can you think of anybody that likes problems? Maybe a mathematician starting with math problems. But I'm talking about problems that affect your life. Generally, every human being I've ever met does not like problems that affect their life. You know what I mean? They just don't. I mean, I haven't encountered one that has. So if you want to mitigate problems that affect your life, be very particular about the company you keep and who you have in your circle, in your space. Because you don't want some of their problems to become your problems, right? Not just because of for making dumb choices, right? If people are making dumb choices, causing problems that cause you problems, that's a problem, at least in my opinion. So what I got out of this was, for as much as I love Dwight, as much as I love Tulsa King, it's like, bro, sometimes, like, Dwight, you need to stop and think and stop reacting. Another thing in the show I noticed today as well is that there's a scene with our mind, right? And our mind's talking to his wife. They're having dinner and they're arguing. And then our mind takes his plate of food and he just throws it right at the wall. And the first thing I'm thinking, like, man, what a waste of good food, bro. So I'm like, man, you just wasted that good plate of food, bro. What are you doing? But he just reacted so quick. The lack of control, just the emotions came over me. He said, bam, I'm throwing this plate of food at the wall, right? And in the show, a couple of the characters do seem to just react so quickly to situations. In my current way of life, I just try not to really move like that. I want to think before I act is kind of the way I'm moving. But in the show, a lot of those guys just react immediately. And just like, I'm just thinking like, probably not a good look. But that happens quite a bit in the show, a lot of just reacting without stopping, pausing, and responding, thinking about it. But it happens. I'll be completely honest. Sometimes the surprise of a rash, aggressive act can stoke a little bit of anxiety and fear of people. I'll be real with you guys. I've felt that before in certain situations. So if we learned anything from the episode this week, Let's take time to pause and respond and think before we react so aggressively and hostile and emotionally. Let's get those emotions under control and let's respond in a calm, relaxed, logical thinking manner. Or maybe not. Maybe you just want to throw a plate of food at the wall harshly and aggressively and emotionally. Maybe that's what's called for, right? Maybe sometimes you want to do that. But in this economy, bro, inflation, wasting a good plate of food, man, probably not a good look. So anyways, Tulsa King is fantastic. It's one of the best gangster shows, movies I've seen, period, to be real. I've seen a lot of gangster film and shows over the years, and this is at the top of the stack to me. It's got Sly Stallone, bro. Like anything he's in, I just love it. I just love that dude so much. He's such a dope actor. So yeah, Tulsa King is dope. If you've not seen it, go over to Paramount Plus and check it out. You will not be disappointed. Because come on, you know. Ever since you were young, didn't you always want to be a gangster? Didn't you always want to be a gangster, right? Yeah, you know you did. You know you always wanted to be a gangster. So live vicariously through Dwight the Journal. Watch Tulsa King over at Paramount Plus. It's a dope gangster flick. Check it out. So that's all I want to talk about this week. I went to Tulsa King once again. It's 2023. The new year is here. Come on, let's make this year great, fantastic, and awesome. So let's grow. Let's get it. Let's expand our mind this year. So yeah, that concludes the podcast. And until next time, we'll see you. It's time to start living the life you've imagined. Henry James. Until next time, it's Captain Peace.
The Captain Talks Flicks.